What is your favourite unsolved zombie cipher? Which game map is it from? Thanks in advance. Okay, so I would say a couple of my favourites are actually in Voyage of Despair.
The bad guys are there. There's a good chance my father is too.
What's going on, everybody? This is DK Dynamite, and I have something really exciting for all you guys today. So, I love Easter eggs just as much as the next person who plays Black Ops 4 Zombies, and as of recently, I put an immense amount of interest into the unsolved Easter eggs thread over on the COD Zombies Reddit, and there was one unsolved Easter egg that really struck my attention, and it's the one referring to Jason Blundell and how his favorite unsolved Easter egg in Black Ops 4 is currently on Voyage of Despair. He also brought that up in his recent interview on National 115 Day when he took over the Treyarch Twitter. So I was thinking about it and I'm like, you know what? This has to be a cipher. I highly doubt there are any more special weapon quests on Voyage, and obviously the upgraded shield was found just a couple of months ago, right after I believe the main Easter egg was solved. But I think a cipher is still laying around Voyage somewhere, and I was playing Gauntlet on Voyage, obviously, for a couple of days straight until I got the flawless no strike challenge done, and I noticed on the top deck there is a very mysterious window that is just open, and you can see it stands out because the other windows next to it are boarded up. This is the only one that's actually open to where you can see inside, and if you go prone, you could notice that this very interesting pattern is illuminated in this room, but the rest of the room is pitch black, so I figured there's some type of emphasis on that design in the room, but I couldn't figure out what it was, and obviously that's not a cipher, that's not something you could decode, that's not something that really stands out to mean something. It could just be a simple design that they chose for Voyage of Despair. Maybe it's a design that was unique to the Titanic, maybe it's just some reused asset. It's nothing too big, right? So I didn't put much thought into that room anymore. I kept playing Unsinkable, which is the Gauntlet on Voyage, for a few days straight, going for that Unsinkable Flawless Challenge. And just the other day, I hopped into a regular match of Voyage, which is ranking up some weapons and getting some more XP, and I decided to go back to that window over here on the deck. And something inside of me just clicked and said, you know what, try to illuminate the rest of the room. See what else is in there, because the fact that one little area is illuminated and the rest of it isn't has to mean something. It has to be a nod to actually illumination itself. So something clicked and I threw a Wraithfire in this room just to see what would actually be in the room once I could actually see inside, and what do you know, there's a fireplace sitting in the right corner of this little room, and it's just a normal dining room, or it could be a bedroom, whatever this room may be, but there's actually a fireplace in here, and when you illuminate it, you could see towards the bottom of the fireplace itself is a QR code. Now, I almost flipped out when I saw this because I know not a single person has posted about this specific little room, not about the QR code or about illuminating the room with the Wraithfire. I know that not a single person has spoken about this, so I was really excited to try to get to the bottom of it and to figure out what this QR code meant. So I attempted to record the footage of me looking at this QR code with a sniper, screenshotting it with my Elgato, and then trying to scan it with my phone. I have a couple of QR code readers, and unfortunately nothing worked. I really couldn't get this to work, but I ended up going in theater mode trying to see if I can glitch my way into that room using free roam, and I didn't have any luck. But what I did notice is that there is a light feature or a light kit in theater mode where you can light up anything in front of you, and even though I can't free roam, I could still light up the room itself using the feature in theater mode, and you can clearly see the QR code as bright as day without even throwing a Wraithfire. As long as your sniper scope isn't covering the QR code itself, you can clearly see the QR code in high res. So using this light feature on theater mode, I attempted to take more pictures with my Elgato, and finally I got a screenshot that was so clear, and I'll put it on screen, I got one that's so clear that I was able to scan it with my phone, and I got the following message. There's a rage within you the others do not know. It may be your undoing. Now, I'm assuming this was supposed to be found before the main Easter egg on Voyage was actually solved, because this cipher is actually referring to Bruno and how he's part of the Order. And obviously, before the main Easter egg was solved, we didn't know that. We didn't know there was a member of the group that was actually evil and will eventually be cleansed in a later DLC map, since once again, there is going to be a map in between Voyage and 9. Bruno is cleansed in 9, but in terms of when he got cleansed, can only be answered with a DLC map that takes place in between these two maps. Now, let me know what you think of this down below in the comment section. How cool is it that they put in a QR code cipher here on Voyage of Despair that directly references evil Bruno within the Chaos storyline? But this has been DK Dynamite. Shout out to everybody who's involved in the unsolved Easter eggs thread over on the COD Zombies subreddit. I'll be active as much as I can on that thread, trying to debunk and figure out what some of those unsolved Easter eggs actually are. My next goal is to figure out what the deal is with that Golden Spork upgrade over on Blood of the Dead. I'm really interested in figuring out what exactly that could lead to and whether or not it's still a broken quest within Black Ops 4. But that's about it. Stay tuned in for more Black Ops 4 Zombies gameplay news and coverage, and peace out, everybody.
I don't trust it. It's looking at me funny. Thank you.